Hi there! In our last video, we learned about the basics of VTubing with Mannequin Character Generator and Puppet String VTuber Tracking. However, some of you might have this question. I'm not interested in VTubing, and since Mannequin is also described as a tool for making visual novels, isn't this useless for that purpose? Well, the answer is thankfully no. Today we will learn how to use Mannequin's exported Inochi 2D models with Inochi Creator to make visual novel sprites, or maybe just a nice static image for your social media posts, video thumbnails, and whatever you want, really. First, let's get Inochi Creator, which can be downloaded from itch.io, Steam, or GitHub. After done downloading, let's open our previously exported INX file with it. Let's adjust the user interface first to make it more comfortable. We can also move the preview around by right-click and drag, or zoom in and out by using our scroll wheel. Now, let's open the Parameters panel by clicking View at the top menu bar, then choosing Parameters. Here in the Parameters panel, we can move various sliders to adjust our character's pose or expression. Keep in mind that not every slider can be moved, as some of them are tied to physics calculation. As we can see, there's a lot of parameters available. However, all Inochi 2D models exported by Mannequin have pre-sorted parameters, grouped into several sections with distinct coloring. Red for eyebrows, green for eyes, purple for mouth, and so on. After we're done with the sliders, now it's time to export this character to a transparent PNG. To do this, open the File menu, Export, Image, then choose PNG. After choosing our file location, make sure Allow Transparency is enabled before clicking the Save button to ensure our exported image has a transparent background. And we're done! Now let's go for a bit more complex endeavor by utilizing a partially rigged model. To do this, go back to Mannequin and open our character file. Go to the body sidebar and change pose by clicking the folder icon at the right side of our character's pose name. Now, let's disable Inochi 2D filter by clicking the purple C icon up top. Here we can see that our pose options have risen, with some of them marked with the C icon and the rest are unmarked. These unmarked poses are not compatible with Inochi 2D. Exporting to Inochi 2D using these poses will result in a partially rigged model, therefore unusable for VTubing. However, this time we are only looking forward to making static images of our characters, so we can still make use of these. Let's choose one of the unmarked poses. After we're done, let's go to the export sidebar. In the rigged output section, we can see that the final status message is now different from our previous video. As expected, now it's said that our exported file will be partially rigged. Let's export anyway and open the file in Inochi Creator. We can see that compared to our previous file, which is fully rigged, some sliders are now unavailable or not working properly. However, some of them are still usable, such as head movement and face expression here. Let's try to export this character into a PNG image again. Same as before, move the sliders that works properly to adjust the pose and expression to our preference. Then open the File menu, Export, Image, and choose PNG. As we can see, now we have more options to pose our character for static images. However, how do we save our parameter settings for use in the future? In case you haven't noticed yet, every time we open our exported character file in Inochi Creator, all sliders will be reset to their default position. This can be annoying if we already have our favorite values for each of the available parameters. So let's save our favorite parameter values via the animation system. To do this, click the Edit Animation button at the top right. Then open the Animation List and Timeline panel by clicking each respective entries in the View menu. In the Animation List panel, click the plus button at the bottom. Give it a name and click Create. Now, let's click the Reset Parameters at the toolbar up top to make sure we're starting from scratch. Afterwards, let's change one of the parameter sliders, for example, the head pitch and yaw. After we're done, click the plus button on the right side of the corresponding parameter. Let's adjust several more parameters. Just as before, move the slider and click the plus button after we're done. Now, let's save this character file. After closing it and opening it again, we can go back to Edit Animation, choose our previously created animation, then click Play to load our previous parameter settings. Then we can export our character again to PNG file just like before. Keep in mind that we can create multiple animations in a single file, so more than one pose can be stored using this trick. That's all for today. As usual, stay tuned for our future videos, which will come as the development of both Mannequin and Puppet String continues. Subscribe to this channel to keep updated. Until next time!